Donald Trump and a Muslim billionaire. Many of the Middle East's richest have been silent on Trump's proposed ban on Muslims entering the United States. Until now. The man who built the world's tallest building, the Burj Khalifa, is speaking out for the first time. Our exclusive interview in Dubai with Mohamed Alabbar, who decided not to do a deal with Trump, comes as Trump is pushing to do more business in the Middle East. Trump Hotel spokesperson telling Out Front this week that Trump is in active talks with multiple partners in the region, a place where Trump desperately wants to grow. But Trump's comments about banning Muslims have already taken a very serious toll. This golf course under construction in Dubai used to have Trump's name emblazoned at the entrance. Now, there is no trace of it. And this week, at the world's biggest mall, I saw that Trump-branded products are still banned from the shelves of the popular retailer Lifestyle. Mohamed Alabbar tells me it will be very hard for Trump to do business in the Mideast now. Alabbar also divulging new details about the world's tallest tower. He tells me he is breaking ground on the Santiago Calatrava design tower in July, and it will be 100 meters taller than the Burj Khalifa. That is the length of a football pitch. I began our exclusive conversation by asking him if rising oil prices are boosting real estate deals in Dubai.
Business is good. I must say that probably towards the end of last year, a little bit of concern, interest rate, oil prices, issues in China. But I think things are stabilizing a little bit. I think the year is looking much better than we thought.
And you had said earlier this year, I think your words were, you were really scared. When oil prices were significantly lower.
Yes.
Has it changed dramatically since then?
I think, I think psychologically people stabilize their minds that they can deal with lower oil prices, because that's only natural. Even if it comes down to 30 or 35, I think we need to find that balance in the head so people get used to that, then moved up a little bit. I think people are scared about effect of China, which is a little better. So I think we digested the whole situation, number one. Number two, I think it got a little better than we thought.
In terms of oil prices, obviously you mentioned they had gone down to incredible lows. Now they have come back a little bit. A lot of the buyers I know that you're dealing with property here in downtown Dubai are from the Middle East, from places like Saudi Arabia.
Yes.
Have you seen them start to come back as buyers as oil prices have come up a little bit, or have you not noticed a change yet?
Interesting that even when the prices were low at the 2028s, we didn't really see a lot of change in the buying pattern. I would say a little bit, but not much. Now, as it really went up to the 40 plus, I think the activity has improved. Now, we also changed as a company because we went totally digital. And we think that we are marketing better, we are selling better, we're serving our customer better.
We're here, obviously, in front of the fountain and the Burj Khalifa. People want to be here because of the building, because of the fountain. You have been advertising around the world. People may have seen your advertisements, whether it was in the FT or Architectural Digest or wherever it may have been. But you're eliminating all that? It's going to be all digital now?
Well, I think that's where the value is. I think that's where the eyeballs are, and I think that's the way we're going. So we're going totally digital, the way we do business. I think there is an 80% shift in how we do business, and we've done it all in one night. We took the risk, and the reward is really huge.
I mean, so this means instead of in magazines, it's really going to be online, where
no
you're
more.
Marketing,
no more.
Buying.
Well, you spend 2.5 hours on your iPhone and you're on Samsung. We want to be talking to you. We're not interested in the 200,000 prints of a newspaper anymore, and it costs you so much.
We don't even know
if you've looked at us or not. This way, we are really in touch with you.
So obviously, you got the Burj Khalifa here, the tallest building in the world. Let me just ask you about the building. I mean, what is the hardest part about maintaining it?
Well, safety. I think we just want to make sure that our customers are safe, and to make sure that no incidents, and you know, the address fire was a scary thing for us.
Right, which obviously right behind us.
Behind us, in here. So I think safety is number one in how we deal with the building. But I think the building is doing really well, behaving very well. All the systems are operating well. We've got, you know, earthquakes every once in a while coming through from Iran. Stands really quite well. Customers are happy. But I think it's our duty to really make sure that we just maintain it and look after it, because this is just one of the most gorgeous buildings in the world, and we want to keep it that way.
And you have, I know I always talk to you about the window cleaning, how it's every single day, all day long, they're cleaning the
and
windows.
And we have a lot of dust in the Middle East, huh?
Right.
A lot of humidity.
And now you're going to build a building that's going to be even taller, right here in Dubai.
Well, yes. I think you know, it's human evolution. You know, we all learn, get better, and we must go and do better things. And, you know, of course, I'm a developer, but I'm looking for value of to enhance value for the real estate. But also I'm driven by my, you know, my pride of my country. The United Arab Emirates is a place that given me so much in my life. And I have to contribute. Maybe I've done one. I can do one more.
And that's the driver? I mean, the big question is, of course,
truly,
why?
I think truly it's just I love my country so much. And I love my company so much. And it adds value to my real estate. And it's fun to do. I mean, I get to do this in my lifetime. And I do another. I mean, I'm so lucky to do these things and add value and celebrate it. And you know, when kids come and look at the Burj and they look at the new Burj, mm-hmm. for them, these are so special moments. And I think for us to add these special moments and pride for our people in the Middle East, mm-hmm. I think it's so special.
So the new building, is it going, it's literally going to hang from cables? How is it going to work?
Well, I would say the cables are going to support the building for us to basically stand and stay gorgeous. And the cable are almost like jewelry that are going to be hanging from the building itself. And Calatrava have done a fabulous job.
And so what's going to be in the tower? I know it's not a tower like this.
Yes.
I mean, it's not going to be full of apartments.
We have a boutique hotel, and we have a few floors of gardens, observation, restaurants, and function halls. The plaza will be much bigger than this plaza, just because of sheer size of the tower and the cables. But then what we do with the plaza, and how can we beautify it, and how it adds real estate to everything around it. So it will be quite a job.
So this mall is the biggest mall in the world where we are right now, Dubai Mall.
Today, one of the biggest, yeah.
The mall that's going to be there is going to be bigger.
We want to go bigger.
You really think there's capacity for another mall that's
bigger?
Well,
you've been here Thursday. I think it's getting dangerous. Our corridors, even though we put them 30% bigger when we designed this, shopping corridors are 30% bigger than traditional shopping mall corridors. And the reason is that 50% of our population are women, and women in the Middle East are the greatest shoppers. We still get it wrong. I think we need to do more. We need to get it a little bigger. But I think size is not the issue, Erin. Is that I think architecture, technology, and changing the shopping experience. Because with the digital world, with e-commerce, how can we combine all that and create that atmosphere that you really don't go shopping anymore? I think we're going for the environment, to entertain, to eat, to communicate, and shop, by the way. But technology is going to drive it all for us.
And so you're going to build a whole neighborhood. There'll be apartment buildings, hotels.
Yeah, it's about double the size of this. This is about 500 hectares. That's a little bit more, 1,200 hectares.
1,200.
But the beauty of it is that it's just right on Dubai Creek, which is a really historic site. So we'll have 2 kilometers of waterfront.